Good morning, students. Today I am going to explain the lesson, Our National Symbols. So what is the name of the lesson? Our National Symbols. So in this lesson, we learn about the national symbols. So every country has its own national symbols. So like this, India has also their own national symbols. In this lesson, we learn about the important information about our national symbols of India. So Indian national symbol depicts the country's image and have been chosen very carefully. The national animal tiger symbolize the power. The national flower lotus symbolize the purity. The national tree banyan symbolize the immortality. The national bird peace symbolize the elegancy. Peacock symbolize the elegancy, and national fruit mango symbolize the tropical climate of India. Similarly, our national song, our national anthem were the source of inspiration during the freedom struggle. The national emblem of India depicts four lions standing back to back, symbolizing the power, courage, pride, confidence. So hockey was at its peak when it was adopted at the national game of India. Here is some information about the national symbols of India. So you know, India tiger is our national animal, lotus is our national flower, banyana tree is our national tree, the peacock is our national bird, mango is our national fruit. So like this, everyone has its own aim. What that means? National animal tiger symbolize the power, lotus purity, banyan tree immortality, national peacock elegancy, now mango it is a tropical climate of India, it shows the tropical. So like this, India has its own national emblem, national song, national anthem. The national song and national anthem or source of inspiration during the freedom struggle. Understood? So next you learn about the what are the information about the national symbols of India. First one is national flag. National flag is a horizontal tricolor of deep saffron at the top, white in the middle, dark green at the bottom. Is equal proportion. The ratio of width of flag its length is 2 to 3. In the center, white band is navy blue wheel, which represent the chakra. The top saffron color indicates the strength, the courage of the country. The white middle band indicates the peace and truth with dharma chakra. The green shows the fertility, growth and auspiciousness of the land. So our national flag has horizontal tricolor, the saffron, white and green. Understood? The saffron show, what is the saffron shows? At the top, white middle, green dark in bottom. What is the ratio of our flag? 2 to 3. In center, there is a white band, is a navy blue wheel, which represents the chakra. The top saffron color indicates the strength. Understood? What it indicates the saffron? Strength and courage of the country. In the white band indicates the peace and truth with the dharma chakra. The green shows the fertility, growth and auspiciousness of the land. It is that the wheel which appears the abacus of the Saranath lion capital of Ashoka. Its diameter approximate to width of the white band and it has 24 spokes. The design of the national flag was adopted by the Constituent Assembly of India in 22 July 1947. So when we hoist the flag, we follow some rules. Which are the important rules we follow when hoisting the flag? First one, no flag or emblem should be placed either above the national flag or its right. Understood? Another, all other flags to be placed to the left of the national flag if they are hung in the line. When, third one, when the national flag is carried in the procession or parade, it shall be marching right or in front of the center of the line if there is a line of other flags. Next, normally national flag should be shown thrown over the important government building like Rashtrapati Bhavan, Parliament House, Supreme Court of India and High Court, the Secretariat and Commissioner Office, etc. National flag or any imitative of its must not be used for purpose of trade, business or profession. The national flag should always be taken down in the evening at sunset. Understood? National flag should be always taken down in the evening at sunset. So these are all the rules while hoisting the flag. Next one is national emblem. So the state emblem is the adaptation from the Saranath lion capital of Ashoka. So where you have adopted this lion? Saranath, lion capital of Ashoka. In the original, there are four lions standing back to back round the abacus with frieze carrying the sculptures. High relief of an elephant, a gallop horse, a bull or lion separated by entering the wheel over the bell-shaped lotus. Carved out the single block of polished sandstone, the capital crowned by the wheel of law. Law means Dharma Chakra. The emblem was actually adopted by Indian government with lot of honor in 26 January 1950. However, the representatives and official symbols display three out of the four lions along with famous Dharma Chakra right in the center of the base presently. A bull, horse, company of the lions at the both sides. The bright and prominent face Satyameva Jayate in Devanagari script of India and emphasized the base. The powerful and dignified idea, truth alone trumps, has been demonstrated for the people of India. Understood? This is the about national emblem. The importance of national emblem. Next is national anthem. Next one is national anthem. The national anthem of India, Jana Gana Mana. Which is the national anthem? Jana Gana Mana. It was composed originally in Bengali language by Rabindranath Tagore. Adopted in Hindi version by the Constituent Assembly as the national anthem of India, 24 January 1950. It was first sung on 27 December 1911 at Kolkata session of the Indian National Congress. The complete song consists of five stanzas. How many stanzas? Five stanzas. The first stanza contains the full version of national anthem. And playing the time of full version, the national anthem is approximately 52 seconds short. Version consists in the first and last lines of the stanza is also played a certain occasion. Understood? So you know Janaganamana, there is a, all of you open the page number 64. So you read the Janaganamana. Understood? Next, national song. Which is our national song? The song Vande Mataram, composed in Sanskrit by Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, was the source of inspiration of the people in their struggle for freedom. It was the equal status with Janaganamana. On January 24, 1950, the President Dr. Rajendra Prasad came with statement and Constituent Assembly. The song Vande Mataram, which has played a historic part in the struggle for Indian freedom, shall be honored equally with Janaganamana and shall have equal status with you. Understood? With it. Initially, the Vande Mataram was national anthem of India, but after independence, Janaganamana adopted the national anthem. This was done because non-Hindi communities in India has considered the Vande Mataram is biased. These communities left that nation was represented by the Ma Durga in the song. So that it's why it was made the national song of India, not national anthem. So there is a Vande Mataram is given. I read the poem Vande Mataram. Sujalam Sutphalam Malayaja Sitalam Sasya Shyamala Mataram Vande Mataram Shubhra Jyotsna Pulakita Yamini Pulla Kusumita Drumadala Shobini Suhasini Sumadura Bhashini Sukadam Varadam Mataram Vande Mataram. So this is the national song written by Bankimchand Chatterjee. Understood? Next, you know national animal. Which is the national animal of India? Royal tiger. The national animal of India is a bright yellow color striped animal with short coat. The scientific name of Royal Bengal tiger is the Monthera tigris. Royal Bengal tiger stroll freely in the den of mangrove forest. The national animal of India, Royal Bengal tiger, symbolizes the grace, potency, ability, enormous power. Royal Bengal tiger is the pride of India. It represents the prosperity of wildlife. Tigers are found in almost every corner of India, except in northwestern region in the contiguous countries such as Nepal. Next one is national bird. Peacock was declared the national bird of India in 1963 because it was entirely part of Indian custom and culture. Peacock is the symbol of grace and beauty. Another reason why the peacock was chosen as the national bird because it is a precious presence across the country. So much of that even common people are familiar with the bird. Moreover, no other country had peacock as its national bird either. The peacock fulfilled all these and hence become the national bird of India. Understood? So you learn about national bird. Next is national flower. Which is our national flower? No, lotus. Lotus is our national flower. So is very significant position of Indian mythology. It is a flower of goddesses Lakshmi and symbolize the wealth, prosperity and fertility also. It grows very uniquely and dirty water with long stalk for above the water, bearing the flower on the top. The lotus flower remains the untouched from impurity. It symbolizes the purity, achievement, long life and good fate. So next one is national fruit. Which is our national fruit? Mango. Mangoes are the native to India and thus truly Indians. They were immemorial. Mangoes have been cultivated in India and ancient times as well. Deliciousness and mangoes have been defined by the many renowned poets. The great Mughal emperor Akbar had planted above the 1 lakh mango trees in Lucky Bhag in Darbhanga. So next is national game. Which is our national game? Hockey. Still, it is the national game. It is the national game of India. Hockey was declared the national game very popularly in the game as golden era during the 1928 to 1956 when India won the 6 consecutive gold medals in the Olympics. Hockey was considered as the national game because it is an unmatched distinctions and incomparable talent at that time. At the time, India had played 24 Olympic matches and won all of them. Next, last one is national tree. Which is our national tree? Banyan. The immunity banyan tree is command the great presence in the rural settings of India. The very size of the banyan tree makes a habitat for long number of creatures. For centuries, banyan tree has been the central point for the village community of India. Understood? So these are all the things we learn in this lesson. What do you learn in this lesson? We learn about national emblems. What is the name of the lesson? National symbols. So these are all the national symbols. National flag should always be taken down in the evening of sunset. Banyan is the national tree of India. Hockey is the national game of India. Lotus flower has its very significant position in Indian mythology. Peacock is the symbol of grace and beauty. The complete song consists of 5 stanzas. Understood? So these are all the things we learn in this lesson. Understood, children? So in next class, I will continue. Till now, take care. Goodbye.